All right, good afternoon, guys. Disclaimer is going to be on the left for 5 seconds. Okay, so today is Friday, July 28th, 2023. We're currently sitting short two contracts, sitting in 5 points of drawdown, and we were up to 20 points of drawdown. So, ergo, why I'm only on two contracts. The price has been drawing up to Thursday, the 27th of July's AM session high, which came in at 15,904 evens, but I don't think at this point we are going to get there. So the market forms something of a model 2022. And so what do I mean by that? Well, we have a lot of different PD arrays that are saying this thing should go down. Number one, we have high, low, higher high. That's an ICT bearish breaker. But what we have, guys, is we have buy stops taken. So we were up, I mean, literally 300 points. So yeah, buy stops were taken, guys. If you're up 300 points, buy stops were taken. All right, but buy stops were taken. And then we had a displacement lower that formed a fair value gap. We traded back into that fair value gap, and now we're going lower, guys. That's a model 2022. It's basically a head and shoulders, but not exactly. So anyways, that's a model 2022. And I believe that the New York PM session is slated to go down. So I am going to be listening to music, watching this trade. If we get a good trade here, that'll probably be my only trade of the day. I think we're going to draw. I also, guys, wanted to let you know that we have the Thank God It's Friday model in play. So I have 20% and 30% of the weekly range notched out. So there's TGIF 20%, TGIF 30%. Let's take a look at our daily candle. So you can see we're drawing up to Thursday's high, but I don't think we're going to make it to Thursday's high. I'm pretty convinced at this point we're not. So, 15-minute chart. They're trying to hang the price up here, but I don't think it can stay up here forever, guys. So anyways, there's TGIF 20%, there's TGIF 30%. And then, of course, we have opening range gap down here. So, I think the PM session is going to reverse the AM session, but we shall see, guys. I'm going to make some coffee, turn off the camera for a minute, and yeah. All right, so I had a guy comment in my video like, you don't explain what you're doing. Look at the freaking chart, bro. Are you kidding? You're a clown, bro. Come on now. I don't explain what's in the chart. What do you think all this stuff, the drawings on my chart, what do you think that is? Thank God it's Friday 20%. Thank God it's Friday 30%. That's one of his models. You have an order block mean threshold. That's a model. You have an opening range gap. That's a model. The New York PM open. That's timing. All right, I'll listen to some music then on my phone.
Hey guys, in this video, I want to discuss something that
the month-over-month rate of inflation is going down, right? But they don't, what, here's what they don't tell you. They don't tell you year-over-year our inflation is like 20% or something. I mean, it's absolutely god-awful. The rate of increase has slowed down, but it's still going up. Your food still costs you more. So last month it went up, they said that CPI went up 3%, and but think about that, right? CPI gets released, I think, every month. So it's still going up. The Fed says we want to target 2% inflation. Okay, well, we're still at, officially, we're still at 3.5%. And I mean, everybody knows what the Fed has to do if it actually wants to combat inflation. I mean, we've got to really be at 8, 9, 10% Fed funds rate, right? But they don't want to do that because, you know what would really crash the market is the day that they come out with a surprise rate hike and say we're going up to 8, 9% interest rates. I mean, that would really do it. Yeah, so last night I followed through with the game plan that I told you about, and I've been exercising a lot of risk management, and it does look like today I'm gonna end up at least over 2,400. And then I might be able to get under contract and start making money next week. So, I know. So I'm at 1,070 subscribers now, and 1,250 watch hours. So that's moved up about, since the last time I talked to you, that's moved up about 30 hours or 40 hours. So still got work to go. Obviously, I understand that this is going to take time. Hey, I met a really interesting guy from, he's from Corpus, but he lives in Sugar Land, Texas. And I was talking to him yesterday. And guess what he does for a living? No, he's a country music singer, but he does everything freelance. And he does it on social media. And he's got a really good voice. But he's kind of doing what I'm doing. He's 29 years old. He's got a really good voice, but he makes content in the same way that I do, right? He makes music, and he does. Yeah, I mean, he was showing me some stuff. He does really well with it. He's been offered record labels, and I guess he said he didn't want to make music for somebody else. But anyways, I just thought it was cool that I met somebody who was kind of doing something similar, and I mean, from what he was showing me, he was doing pretty well with it. He's got a really good voice too. At the pool, he sounds like, real thick, like he's coming out of the country, but he's from Corpus, so kind of sounds like he's coming off a cattle ranch, but I don't think he does. So. Yeah, I don't know. Well, I mean, everything from a, I don't believe in fundamentals at all. Like, the market is completely irrational. I mean, if you really believe that the NASDAQ should be at 15,850 points, I mean, I've got a bridge to sell you. Like, it's just, I don't believe. I mean, look, hey, you know, I've been talking to a few girls here and there, and they're all working like three jobs. They all say the same thing. And no, seriously, they all say that. And it's like, people are being squeezed out. Like, you know, the average American income is $40,000 a year, $50,000 a year. And I don't even know how you, at the end of the day, how you live on that. It used to be enough to live off of, right? It would be, you know, God, that's not a lot of money. Yeah, that's probably right. Yeah, but anyways, hey, I wanted to tell you something. If I could get on my statistics. Have you watched any more of my trading sessions? I did, yeah. Over text message. I could send it to your... Do you have your email in front of you right now? Okay. sringnald@yahoo.com. Sure, I will. Okay, it's just going to be link. You just click on the link and it'll take you right to it. It's not like, by the way, it's not like really, the thing about good day trading is that it's actually pretty boring. Like, you just kind of watch the numbers, you know. Anyways, it's not like action packed or anything. It's just, you know. So, but I wanted to say this, and I'm only saying this because, you know, I don't really have anybody to talk to about this other than people I talk to on YouTube, and I don't really talk with them. You know, I understand I'm not making a real income off of this yet, but I promise you that I've made a massive amount of progress in terms of the models that I'm using, in terms of trading at the right times of the day, risk management. You know, I'm hoping to be able to show some real results from that soon, but I have to stay positive, right? I do believe in being positive. And, you know, just to let you know, I've made a lot of progress, like mentally, patience, discipline, you know. And, hey, by the way, do you mind if maybe I could send you like a couple pictures of what I'm looking like now? Are you able to pull up your phone while I'm on the phone with you or not? Okay, I understand. Yeah, you can see my facial definition now. I do push-ups, but no, I don't have any weights down here. I've just been doing a lot of walking and swimming. Yeah. No, it's, you know what's so crazy is that when you start losing weight and you can see the definition on your face, right? It makes a huge difference. So I heard Rachel was, you said she was losing some weight as well. Okay, well, I will keep you posted on how I'm doing. The way that it's looking right now, if I continue to trade with tact and discipline and patience and using the models that I'm familiar with, you know, it could happen next week. And then, you know, I'll let you know. My current plan, like I said, is that I did tell you that I have like a $700 bonus with my first paycheck if I get there, right? So my plan was, I'll keep you posted, okay? Hey, by the way, I wanted to say, can I tell you one more thing? Last night, I went over to the Island Market and I bought anchovies for the first time, these little Spanish anchovies. They're actually really good. They weren't salty at all. They were like really good. So, yeah. And by the way, I was doing some research on like, brain food, because, you know, I'm trying to live, you know, a high performance life, right? And all the stuff about sardines, anchovies, skipjack, salmon, like fish is really good for you. It's got that high in omega-3s. And I'm telling you, I've never thought more clearly in my entire life. I cut out all the bad food and now I've switched it to a lot of the better food. And it really does make like a performance difference. So I've been eating skipjack. I ate anchovies last night. They're actually really good. I mean, everybody says that they're nasty and salty. That was not what they tasted like at all. They tasted really good, actually. So they're kind of like, you know, little sardines, but they don't taste quite like sardines. So, you know, my recommendation to you, if you're... Yeah, anchovies are not sardines. They're like a little Spanish fish, and they used to like put them on pizza. Okay. No, they're both like little bait fish. Yeah, little cans. Yeah, and so up at Island Market they've got all these wild caught fish. So I got skipjack, I have salmon, I have tuna, I have these things called kippers, which are like, they're kind of like little mackerel. So it depends on the fish. If it's tuna, or like swordfish, is a predatory fish that eat other fish, they carry the mercury. So like bait fish, like anchovies, have almost no mercury in them. But if I were to, I do eat a lot of tuna, but like the worst one, I think, in terms of mercury is not tuna, even though tuna can carry mercury. It's like swordfish. Well, and the other thing I've got is I got this like crushed olive spread, because they say that olive oil is good for brain function, like healthy fats, and it's pretty good, and it goes well with the fish. And I'm telling you, Dad, it's 100% your diet. Like, if I'm telling you, if I would have eaten like this in law school, it would have made a huge difference. I mean, it really is like night and day. Your ability to stay focused and stay calm, and I think you should try it. I think maybe you should incorporate some more fish into your diet. They say that it staves off cognitive decline. So, all right, tell me if you get those pictures. All right, and check your email. Bye-bye.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. In this video,
Okay, guys. That is going to be it for me today. We made $2,800. Fake dollars, guys. Simulated trading. Guys, that's the Thank God It's Friday model. I hope that y'all had a good one, and thank you for watching.